Hi, Rosie Malady here from ownyourownmag.com. Are you looking to create a super funky multimedia online magazine or ebook with video and audio and slideshows embedded into the magazine pages that have this cool 3D flip effect that you've seen on some magazines? Well, if so, you are going to love, 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 love this piece of kit that I discovered for you, which can create awesome, vivid flipping pages from simple PDFs, which you can then add video, audio, and slideshows to. I'm going to show you how easy it is to use and the pros and cons of using it. To be honest, I purchased this software 2 years ago and used it for one of my first online magazine projects. I stopped using it because it was very glitchy at the time and it needed to be uploaded through FTP, and I wanted my client to be able to upload it easier than that. So I was disappointed with it at the time, and I've been using other programs ever since, such as Issue. But recently, someone was asking me about embedding videos into a magazine project they're working on, because multimedia is really the way magazines are going. So I decided to give this program another shot. And when I went into the site, I was delighted to see that the software had a complete makeover, and all the little problems I had with it previously have been ironed out. And it is now dead easy to use for creating multimedia online magazines and publications. It is super easy to use, and you can not only embed YouTube and other videos into your magazine, but also slideshows, audio, hyperlinks, and lots of other good stuff. And it's compatible with any computer or mobile device. Another great thing about it is that you no longer have to fluff around with FTP uploads, which I hate. Embedding your final publication is as easy as copy and pasting a link to your website, which is similar to what I have been doing with Issue. There is a once-off payment for the software. When I bought it, it was a lot more expensive, but it has come down to only $2.99, and you can buy it, as say, for Mac or PC. Make sure you choose the right one though. So if you're using Mac, you choose the Mac one. If you're using PC, use the PC one. I have links to both down below, so you can actually go and view which one is best for you. And it's in the description area, so just pop down there and choose them afterwards. I have also found that the customer service is extremely good. As I said, I bought this about 2 years ago and asked them for the updated version only recently, and within minutes they sent it to me. No questions asked, no extra charges, and any questions I've had have been answered really quickly. So I'm very comfortable recommending this if you want readers to have a full multimedia interactive magazine experience. So let's dive right in and see how this works. So you go up to the top left button and click Import PDF, and you simply select the PDF of your final magazine to upload. Now, if you want to know how to create a magazine from scratch and convert to PDF and do all that good stuff, go over to my site, ownyourownmag.com, and you'll get training and lots of tips and guidelines about online magazine creation. So I've gone ahead and chosen my PDF, and voila, it appears in front of me and is instantly a flip page magazine. It takes a few moments for this to upload, but once it's done, it just pops up there and your magazine is now a flip page magazine. Now you can turn on and off the auto flip and the page flipping sound. I leave it on because I think it's pretty cool. So I don't leave on the auto flip, but I leave on the sound of the page turning, which I just like. So I then choose button options I want. Now I haven't enabled the social media share buttons on this or the download buttons, but there's loads and loads of different options you can choose that you can so you get people to share and everything directly to the magazine. But as I want to people to do that from my website, I keep the toolbar settings to a minimum. I just have the enlarge button and the forwarding button. So to insert a slideshow of images, I go to the edit pages in the toolbar. I select the page I want to put the slideshow on. I then select insert images. Then insert banner. I select the area I want the slideshow to go onto and the effect I want to use. I then go to select images and simply add them one at a time by clicking add images. Once all are chosen that I want to go onto the page and I'm okay with it, I choose photo slideshow and okay.
show you how to add YouTube.
So I'm just going to go ahead and follow through with those instructions. You can just see them on screen here. And then what I'm going to do is show you how to do a YouTube video. So just follow along here with me, and then we'll move on to how to insert a YouTube video. Now I'll show you how to add a YouTube video. I have already got a link to my YouTube video on my PDF, which shows up here when I click on it. I added this, as I say, before I upload it, so it's pretty cool that it actually shows up on this now. And that's where I'm going to copy the info from that I need. Now, I mean, you can do this directly from your YouTube channel. You only need the code of the YouTube video that follows the forward slash. So that's the video ID, and that's all you need. So I'm just going to copy the video ID, here we go, where you can do, I say you can, which you can do directly off YouTube, and it's not a problem. And then I'm going to choose the YouTube icon up in the toolbar and select the area that I want the video to appear in. This is just simply click drag. It's the same as what I did for the slideshow. So this can be as big or as small as you want. And then I'm going to copy the ID into the space provided, and your YouTube video appears. You can change the size simply by dragging the pointers. You then choose when the movie should start and stop, when you enter or leave the page, or when play is pressed. I prefer to choose when click play button is pressed, simply because it saves people embarrassment if they're looking at your magazine in work, or when they're not meant to be looking at your magazine, and if you have something automatically starting like music or a video, it actually puts them in maybe an awkward or an embarrassing situation. So I generally like to leave it that people prefer the play button themselves. And that's it. That's how easy it is to install video and slideshows into your 3D flip page magazine through this brilliant software. The only negative, I would say, is that it doesn't come with many instructions. So a lot of the features are simply found by trial and error. However, it is very clearly laid out, so you can't go far wrong, but still, I still feel I should actually give more tutorials or instructions, because I feel I'm missing out on a lot of the great features it has to offer. But I'm going to explore them, and maybe I'll do more videos about them. If you forgot to add a link to your original doc before turning it into PDF, that's not a problem, as you can simply add a link with this program by clicking on the link, choosing the area of text or image you want it linked to, and add the details. It's as simple as that. I think this will be a great piece of software for a magazine with movie reviews, or maybe if you're doing cooking demonstrations, or any type of reviews for that matter that involve like hands-on how-to videos, where your readers can actually watch the clips while reading your reviews or your instructions. Or for music magazines where you want to have audio samples, for example, or e-courses where you have a manual with video demos and audio tutorials as well as visuals and text. How cool is that? I mean, it's the whole thing. Like, you can be a real hands-on teacher in your e-courses. When you're happy with your magazine, you go to convert and you choose the title and click publish. You let it do its thing, and this can take a few minutes. You'll then get a congratulations uploaded successfully message, and you then share the link from there if you don't have a website, or you can choose to insert it into your website, which is what I'm going to do now. So I'll just show you now how to actually insert it into your website. I use WordPress, so just give me a moment now and I'll call it up here, and we can, I'll show you step by step how to insert it into your website. So to do this, I click insert to site, copy the embed code. I then go to a page on my WordPress site. That's what I use, is WordPress. If you want instructions how to set up a WordPress site, just pop over to ownyourownmag.com and I show you how. And then I have already prepared a page here for this demo. So I choose the text or HTML area, it might be on your site, and I paste the code. There are a few instructions they include, so I remove these and I just leave the code between the iframe brackets. So that's the important bit you need, just the bits that the brackets that are marked iframe. So before and after that, you can delete their stuff. And that's it. I have my multimedia online 3D flip magazine on my site with video and with slideshows and audio and loads of other good stuff. Multimedia publications are definitely where the market is going, so you will be well ahead of the posse with this piece of kit. So all you need are PDFs of your finished magazine, and you can get the software for Mac or Windows. And you don't even have to have PDFs, you can actually buy a version that converts directly from Office to Flip magazine. It's a little bit more expensive, I think it's $349, but I have a link below anyway you can have a look at and see if it's for you. I haven't tried the Office to Flip page, I have to be honest, so I can't say if it's great or not, or if I can recommend that. But the PDF to Flip pages with the embeds are awesome. I have a Mac and that's what I use. As I say, I have a link below to the sites where you can actually purchase this software from, and also a link to my Magazine Creation Academy where you can get lots more free tips and tutorials of how to create online magazines. So I'm Rosie Malidi from ownyourownmag.com. It was great talking to you, and I do hope you found this useful. If you do, please do leave comments below in the area below, and I look forward to catching up with you again.